Hi, my name is Dimitri, and in this video we'll see how you can track daily employee attendance and analyze team reports. Clockify's attendance report shows you daily employee work and break hours, their daily start and end times, their daily capacity, overtime, and time off. Let's see how you can set up user profiles, breaks, and time off settings in order to make practical and effective use of the attendance report. To get started, we first need to set up team profiles. To add a new member, let's go to the team page, and then click Add Full Member, followed by their email address. You can add people one by one, or in bulk by typing multiple email addresses. To add details to a member's profile, click on the three dots next to their name and choose Edit Profile. Now you can add other employee details that can vary from team to team or from employee to employee, such as their week start, their working days, and their daily working capacity. Based on the working capacity, employee overtime hours can be calculated. In the Limited tab, you can add members who don't have an email address or who will have a limited access to your Clockify account. More specifically, people who clock in and out using only the kiosk. No matter if the user is full or limited, you'll have all of their attendance data in the report. You add limited users simply by typing in their name, and then you can edit their profile information in the same way. If everyone has the same start day of the week and the same working days, you can set this information in the workspace settings, which will then automatically be applied to each team member profile. Now let's see how you can track time and breaks. There are multiple ways to track time in Clockify: through a web timer, a timesheet, a kiosk on any device, or a dedicated mobile or desktop app. Whichever method you choose, you can track both your work and break time. However, to track breaks, first we need to enable it in the settings. Let's go to the workspace settings and enable the option to track breaks. While we're here, we can also set a default break project, or create one if it's needed. Let's see how break tracking works in the tracker. On the three dots at the end of the entry field, you can choose the option to track your time, whether it's through a timer or manually. And here you can also choose the break mode to track breaks. Choose this option and you'll notice the entry field now has a different icon. This will help you distinguish between entries that are breaks and entries that are work. Also, the default break project is automatically filled in. So all you need to do is start the timer when your break starts and stop it when your break's over. Tracking breaks in the timesheet works pretty much the same way as when you track time on work. Choose the default break project, enter the break length, and the entry will be saved. To start and stop a break timer in a kiosk, users just have to click on the break button and enter their PIN if it's required. Mobile and desktop apps work just as simple, by switching to a break mode and then logging it through a timer or manually. However your team tracks their work and break time, the attendance report will have it shown. Another important aspect of tracking attendance is tracking employee time off hours. Time off policies let you customize the terms and conditions under which employees can request their time off. So, you create a set of custom time off policies, like paid vacation, sick leave, earned time off, and so on. For each policy, you choose people for which it applies to, and whether it'll be expressed in days or hours. As for policies that are expressed in hours, they let users request time off in minutes as well. Policies can require approval, and admins approve these requests by default. But they can also allow team managers and specific members to approve them. If you choose to express your policy in days, it can be set to allow half-day requests too. The other way in which you can manage time off in Clockify are holidays. Holidays are mostly used to note any national or international non-working days. You can add a color to a holiday to visually distinguish it from other policies and holidays. They don't require approval and are usually applied to everyone, but they can also be applied to some team members or team groups. Choose its date or time period, and if it'll occur annually. Now the attendance report will include approved time off or holiday absence for each team member. Let's see how the attendance report summarizes all of the stuff I just talked about. To get to the attendance report, switch to the team report in the reports label. Now you'll get an overview of each team member's activity by day. You can choose the time period you want to analyze data for. For example, let's choose today. The report will list the start and end times for each team member, their total break and work hours, their daily work capacity, overtime hours, and any time off taken during the day. In the work column, hovering over an exclamation mark will provide you with information about how much less time has been tracked than the person has capacity to work. Besides time period, you can also use filtering to show data for only some people. Or show data for only people who have overtime hours by filtering who logged more than 8 hours in some day, if that's the overall working capacity. Each filter in the attendance report gives you the option to enter exact values by logic smaller than, larger than, or exactly, so you can get specific values. This way, you can filter out and see the specific overtime hours, so you can easily calculate overtime pay for each person, depending on their overtime work. Or you can filter the break data to see if all employees took the necessary breaks throughout the day. However you filter out your attendance report, you can export it as a CSV or Excel file for internal log or further analysis. If you want to learn more about the features I mentioned in this video, make sure to check out our other tutorials. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.